There's a new openSAP course on SAP HANA. It's aimed at developers, business data analysts, and database administrators, and is titled Ride the SAP HANA Wave, Fundamentals and Insights into Cloud Databases. It covers in-memory innovations, cloud-native qualities, and the data and analytics capabilities of SAP HANA, as well as the different deployment options and how to make data available for business insights. The course starts next month, so there's still time to enroll. And the course, of course, like openSAP courses everywhere, is free. So go and enroll now.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. It's that time again, another release of the SAP BTP ABAP environment has dropped. This week, Florian Wall posted a blog post covering some of the major features coming at you in release 2202. He talks about how there has been a reduction in the minimum memory requirements for an ABAP instance running on SAP HANA, which lowers the barrier to entry for smaller use cases. New reuse services and apps have been introduced for maintaining factory and holiday calendars, as well as enhancements to the app for maintaining translations. And of course, new features for the XCO library. There has been many new features added to the ABAP development tools, including support for generating value statements based on internal tables or structures, support for message breakpoints for when you want the debugger to stop on a specific message, and several new enhancements related to ATC, and also editing of number range objects via a new form-based editor, just to name a few. The ABAP RESTful application programming model got a little attention in this release as well, including support for business object interfaces, which can be used to introduce an additional abstraction layer between a wrap-based business object and its business service projection layer, as well as support for creating a CDS entity buffer via Creation Wizard. There are many more features around administration, CI/CD, extensibility, and integration and security. So check out Florian's blog post to get the full story and dive into the details.
We developer advocates have long been fans of SAP Workflow Management, which provides a powerful and flexible visual composition approach to implementing complex processes in lines of business and the wider organization. Last week saw the announcement of SAP Process Automation, which combines SAP Workflow Management with SAP Intelligent Robotic Process Automation, bringing both of these facilities to the next level. You can find out more in the news article from Bhagat Nainani last week. And this week, Murali Shanmukham has published a new deep dive blog post into the topic. So check it out.
Hi, everyone. There's a new release for OpenUI5. Version 1.99 is out. It includes improved features regarding the OpenUI5 OData V4 model, as well as date and calendar related controls, such as the dynamic date range and the single planning calendar. Check it out to get all the details. And in case you're curious what comes after 1.99, it's 1.100.